Relating musically to the college caretaker.
Well, that's a shame because the caretaker's busy. Come with me to fetch coffee. I've had a call about your accommodation fees. The finance department told me you're expecting some money to be transferred into your account, so your check were clear?
Yeah, my gran's left me some money. Not much, but enough.
I'm sorry to be the bearer of bad news, but the money has not been transferred and your check has bounced. You might want to make a few phone calls.
Now, you get to tell me of your dreams. What performances have you seen that have expanded your mind? People go and see a West End show on a Saturday night. They've worked hard all week. They want to be taken away from all that. There's a Murakami quote. What we seek is some kind of compensation for what we put up with. So, what do you seek?
I adore Sam Mendes, but only his theatre work.
Ah, well, like Tom Cruise. Like Mission Impossible. He's wicked.
I'm not into anime or, like, European cinema. I like telly.
Can you tell us why?
Because of Aaron Sorkin and Joss Whedon, because of Russell T. Davies and Josh Schwartz, and because of Alan Ball.
Rachel Griffiths, because when you watch her, you really feel what she's feeling. She takes you into her world.
Good. I was worried we might have another Tom Cruise fan on our hands, and I'd have truly despaired. Right. Small assignments for you all. Monologues. I know you've done them before. Probably done some overacting in sixth form, hamming up the love scenes in Romeo and Juliet, making your mum cry, and everyone else feel slightly nauseous. But this time, I want something different. Something genuine. Try and give me the compensation that I seek. Oh, and Kate, according to the register, you've changed your surname?
Yeah, I had it changed over summer. I didn't want everyone knowing me because...
Well, why not? Your father's famous because he's very, very good. And it could help your career.
Yeah, it could, but getting somewhere because of him, I don't want that.
Good for you.
I know, but you'll be okay. You are safe. I made sure before I left.
You can't do this, Mum. I saw her will. I saw what she said. I don't care if she screwed up. It's what she wanted. You spent it. On what? No. I was going to pay that too, just later, after college or something. But I need it, Mum. I can't afford to be here without it. When do I get to decide? Yeah, really nice, Mum. Really sweet. Why the fuck would I want to come home for Christmas anyway?
I know you're not all dancers, but this is good for you. You have to let go of those long-held teenage boundaries. I want to see you all really trying in this class. Techies, set designers, actors. No whinging, no skiving, no... Please, sir, I forgot to bring my leg warmers. This is the Salinger School. It's not about getting an easy life.
A word now. So you didn't hear the bit where the principal said that all first-year students have to do this?
Oh, seriously, in what way are making me learn the love of dance help me become a better musician?
Didn't you have this conversation at your interview? I mean, I remember explaining that it might make you less annoying.
If some of the best artists ever are annoying, surely that kind of skill is only going to help me.
Look, I argued to get you in here, all right? You're a hard sell. Not many colleges would take the risk. You're incredibly talented, Aria. But everyone is worried.
I won't screw up again.
Yeah. But what I want to hear you say is that you won't hit anyone again.
I won't.
Because if anyone else misses a deadline or gets into a fight, we'll consider what happens to them. But for you, no consideration. Start packing immediately.
I want you to write about something that happened to you, that changed you and turned you into who you are. Make it personal and make it truthful, because understanding these things is part of what makes us better writers. And I would like it finished by class tomorrow. Thank you.
There's a Modest Mouse track. Uses the trumpet. Play the trumpet right, we could try it.
Modest Mouse? You're right, because I want to be a wanker.
Good point. I mean, you've already got your hands full being arrogant and full of shit.
Fuck you, emo boy.
How's it going?
Brilliant.
Wicked.
But there were some girls at the bar wearing the most disgusting outfits.
Mostly writers, obviously. We could have so much fun.
Their answer's still no.
It's so stupid. You could flunk everything and just ask Daddy for a leading role. Fine. I'll go then.
Okay, so, my life did begin in the back of a transit van. I was 25. I wasn't talking to myself. Well, I was talking to myself, but it's because of an assignment.
You decided against the credit over excitement, then?
I was going to go in there, but I...
Sam, we don't need all this tedious fun-making. It's much cheaper and better to sit soberly alone.
Really? We're much cooler.
You're straight edge. Only straight edge sucks, which means I'm going to have to reconsider the whole concept.
We could reconsider it together.
Over alcohol? Lots of cheap alcohol?
I know a place you can get it to be pretty.
I tend to think locations are relevant when it comes to drinking, but I could be persuaded. You got to take that, right?
Hi.
I can crash you a whole one if you like.
I can't, I'm being good.
How's that working out for you?
It's surprisingly difficult.
Can you draw on a well-behaved past for inspiration?
No, I have no real knowledge of being well-behaved at all.
Sounds like you've got an interesting and entertaining life story.
Entertaining for some, maybe, but I'm not sharing it just now. I've got to get back to work.